In the morning of 3rd December, I came to know that there was a leakage from my plant where I was working. So I was worried that how the accident took place. Till that time, I was knowing that it was an accident. But day by day, as I gathered the information about the cause of the disaster, so it was not really all of a sudden an accident. So there are so many factors related to the disaster took place on the night of the December. So as I gather information from various people, I want to share with the media, share with the concerned people what knowledge I do have. So on the 5th of December, I came to contact with the Central Bureau of Intelligence when I was called for the collecting the sample from the 610 tank and other tank for the CBI. So I came to the factory on demand of higher officials. So I took a sample from the connected line of the 610 tank because the tank was empty. There was no MIC in the tank, all the MIC was reacted. But in the connected line, I got some MIC, so I collected sample and from 611 tank and 619 tank. From the sample point, I collected the sample. And I interacted with the CBI people. I asked him, who are you? Then he was telling that I am DYSP CBI, Mr. B.K. Shukla. Then I asked about the background of that official. So he was not signed background. Then I told him that if you don't know anything about the plant, then how you will inspect such a big disaster? So in the meantime, I asked my experience, offer my experience if you want to know anything about the plant. So I am ready to give you information about the plant. So I worked with the CBI for 3 years, up to 87, till the charge sheet was filed in the court. I helped the CBI about the technical information, technical document related to the disaster. And also briefed to the scientists came for the inspection. A team of the scientists came for the inspection to the disaster. I briefed them also about the how the function of the plant. In the meantime, I tried to contact with the media people, but the local media was not given any response about all these things, because I told them it must be confidential, so I don't want to publish my name in the any news. So they were not agreed. So I selected a magazine. I made the correspondent of the magazine, that is India Today magazine. So they published a cover story on the 5th December 1984. The city of death. In that I mention about the summary of the contamination and leak and everything up to that time up on the basis of the available information. Then I gone through various documents related to the disaster. Then in March 85 I made a concrete information about the disaster, how the tank got contaminated and how the gas leak into the atmosphere of Bhopal. That was published in the Business India magazine, this reputed magazine, as a special report on the Bhopal gas disaster. After that, in March 85 itself, there was a Union Carbide Corporation investigation team came here to inspect the disaster, and they published a report on 20th March 85, that is called sabotage report. In that they mentioned that the disaster took place by a disgruntled worker. He introduced hose into the tank, and because of that the contamination that took place. So I contradict that report, explained scientifically using the chemistry and using the information available. So the newspaper, the heading was Bhopal leak caused by major design defect. Support is not accepted. Carbide suppressed two story like this. Union Carbide then by its own report like this. So all the technical information given through these things. After that, I came to know the composition of the gas leak into the atmosphere of Bhopal on that night. That is also I came to know through the Union Carbide Corporation investigation team report. So that was also published in the Business India, the special report. The heading was dangerous of diagnostic delay. Because if you don't know the what type of leak took place on that night, how you will, if you are not able to diagnose, how you will treat the exposed people. So in that report they have mentioned, because of the contamination of the 610 tank material, there was a reaction in the tank. So on that night, 26,000 pound of reaction product along with 54,000 pound of unreacted MIC released into the atmosphere of Bhopal on that night. So those 26,000 pound of reaction product consist more than two dozens of different highly dangerous, highly poisonous chemical that also include hydrogen cyanide, carbon monoxide and other trimerization component like trion, like this. After that, the further there was a reaction into the atmosphere of the unreacted MIC, so everything was appear in the dangerous of diagnostic delay. So in 1988, I was invited in USA in a round table conference that is through the journalist of Business India, Mr. Arun Subbannam. So the subject was Bhopal in India, Bhopal in USA. So there I represented about the Bhopal gas disaster, the reality of the disaster, and even same type of accident can took place in West Virginia also, because if there is safety lapses, there is no proper evacuation plan. So there are chances in West Virginia also. There are so many books written till that time about the various authors. So I gone through some of the books. So all the books written up on the basis of second and third hand information. And there's no reality, no accuracy about the disaster. So there I suggested, I'm not a writer, but I can assemble all the information and gather all the information, and I want to write a book. I need some help from the experts to testify all those information. So the council president gave me assurance, okay, we are going to help you and you write a book. So I wrote a book that was published from USA in 1994, the first edition, that was against the multinational cancer, the Bhopal inside the story. In that I explain everything about the reality of the Bhopal disaster. After that, when second generation become young, so in 2004 the second edition was published after 20 years, and that the technical thing was same, but the update information was there. In the meantime, I got interaction with the various press media, electronic media. I attended so many conferences. In 1991, I represented Bhopal case in Permanent People Tribunal in Yale University, USA. The subject was the industrial hazards and human rights. So there's follow-up of the tribunal. One was in India, 1992. One was in, I think, in Denmark. So I represented in Bhopal also. After that, I attended a conference in IIT Kanpur, and recently, last year, I attended a conference in Central Government Department, Indian Chemical Institute of Technology, Hyderabad. So, still, my work is on whoever coming from any part of the world who want to know any information about the Bhopal disaster, I am sharing my information, because my motto is the reality must reach to the majority of the people, those who are concerned about the Bhopal gas. And if you don't know the reality, then how you will take the lesson from Bhopal? So, but the reality has to be come through the legal process, through the court, because the case was in the court. So last year the decision came and they are taken Bhopal gas disaster like a simple accident, and they have punished the culprit just 2 years of prison and 1 lakh rupees of penalty to them. That's all. But it was not a simple accident. There are so many people are responsible. There are so many factors. The first factor is design. The design decision was taken in the boardroom of West Virginia by the Union Carbide Corporation. They have built a plant, highly economic and double standard plant in Bhopal. It was not a carbon copy of the West Virginia plant. So, and the design was unproven design provided by the higher management, and this all decision taken by the Union Carbide Corporation. Second thing, the Bhopal plant was running under fine chemical license. Because their product was not harmful, so on the basis of the finished product, they got a license, and which is given by the Indian government under fine chemical industry. When there so many accidents took place in Bhopal plant, so our union made a demand to declare this Bhopal plant as a heavy chemical, so the more safety can be, more safety concern may be think by the management and concerned authorities. Third thing is day by day deterioration and the plant safety, whatever provided by the in the design. The safety equipment provided in the Bhopal plant design, they can handle, they can control only normal leaks. Not a single safety equipment can control such a heavy leak or abnormal leakage. If you will compare this thing in West Virginia, you will find an emergency scrubber, emergency flare tower, and the different type of cooling system, a different type of operating procedure. So there's more safety, an advanced safety in the West Virginia plant. Here they were handling MIC just like a water. So in case of accident, in case of emergency, there must be evacuation plan for the community people, because you know in Bhopal there's a very dense population is just near to the factory, just boundary near to the boundary wall of the factory, but there's no evacuation plan, there's no warning system for the community people. That's why the casualty was more. If they would have informed at right time, and there would have an evacuation plan, thousands of people can be saved.